Hola, buenos días o buenas tardes o buenas noches. Hoy vamos a hablar sobre los números del 0 al 100. Okay? So today we're going to talk about numbers from 0 to 100. In the book, you have to know only 0 through 30, but actually to tell time, you have 59 minutes, right? So technically, you have to know up to 59. So we'll learn up to 100, okay? Aquí tenemos 0 al 10. A ver, repitan. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Really try to memorize that, right? Lo tenemos 11 al 20. So, repeat after me, repitan. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 17, 18, 19, 20. So notice 16 has an accent. A few words in Spanish have accents, and you have to memorize those three or four, words that have accents. And one of them is 16, 16, okay? And notice after 16, it has 10, right? And a pattern, 6, 7, 8, 9. But you cannot say 15 or 14. It's illegal, okay? So you have to make sure you memorize 14, 15, etc. Okay, continuamos. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So up to 30, everything is one word, as you notice. Okay, after 30, you will notice it will be more than one word. It will be three words. So there are four numbers in Spanish that have accents. We have 16, 22, 23, and 26. 16, 22, 23, y 26. Okay? So you should study them. De 30 a 40 serían 30. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. Try to pronounce them, okay? 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. 37, 38, 39, 40. So after the 30s is 1, 2, 3 words. You notice? 31. Even though when you read it, it sounds like one word. 32, 33, 34. But when you spell it, it's 1, 2, 3 words. So from 40 to 100, you have to know 40, 50, 60. 70, 80, 90, 100, and 100. Because once you know that, you can just add E something, right? So if you want to say 45, 45. 44, 44. 53, 54. 55, 56. You get the idea. 66, 71, 89, 97. After 100, you have to use 100. So it's 101. There's nothing in between. There's no E over here, okay? There's no end. So if you want to say 112, 112. If you want to say 190, 190. Okay? So just to review, repeat after me. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. 90, 100. Repeat at home, huh? So you can keep reviewing. So when do you use numbers? To count how many something is, right? So you say, ¿cuántos o cuántas hay? How many are there? And how many is a question word that has masculine and feminine. Puede ser masculino o femenino, dependiendo del sustantivo. Sustantivo is noun. So depending on the noun, it can be masculine or feminine when you ask about how many something. Vamos a ver los ejemplos. ¿Cuántos perros hay? ¿Ven que son perros? ¿Cuántos perros hay? Hay 12 perros. ¿Cuántas mariposas hay? Do you notice that I changed to cuántas? Because mariposas is feminine. So you count and figure out the number if you can. And I'll tell you the answer. Hay 50 mariposas. ¿Cuántos gatos hay? Hay 15 gatos. ¿Cuántas rosas hay? Hay 10 rosas. ¿Cuántos tacos hay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hay 5 tacos. ¿Cuántas manzanas hay? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 manzanas. Hay 20 manzanas. ¿Cuántos pájaros hay? You can count at home if you can, huh? Hay 30 pájaros. ¿Cuántas sillas hay? Hay 40 sillas, porque tenemos 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 mesas por 4, by 4, ¿huh? Multiply by 4, serían 40 sillas. Ahora, escriban los números en español. Hagan una pausa, escriban y luego regresen por las respuestas. So try to pause, write the answers on your paper, and then come back to check whether you did it correctly, okay? Y aquí están las respuestas. 33, 26, con acento 26. ¿Recuerdan los cuatro con acentos? 16, 22, 23 y 26. En 14 y 7. Es todo. Continúen practicando. Adiós.